light some of them later, even though I'm not Christian. If I can.
Thank you.
So I took this picture randomly.
It's a church. It's still a church because we have regular masses here on Saturday and Sunday. We can have inside 10,000 visitors. After St. Joseph, we have downtown on the René Lévesque Street, also the St. Patrick's Church, and Mary Queens of the World. And Mary Queens is the Basilica and the Cathedral of Montreal because the bishop lived there. The bishop represents the Pope. And we have also the diocese. Diocese is the place where we administer the parish. So now you see the difference. Huh? Basilica means architectural heritage, cathedral, the seat of the bishop. And I ask you an introduction because often the tourists believe that Notre Dame is a cathedral and its walls is a bed. So here Notre Dame is famous, huh? And one of the reasons it's because the story of Notre Dame is closely related to the story of Montreal. I know that you come from different countries, but do you know when Montreal was founded? Do you know the date of the foundation? I think I have people from Toronto here. Well, people from Canada, maybe at the back. Anyone know the date of the foundation? 16-something? 1642? Yeah? Huh? Do you know the, not the date, but do you know the name of the founder of Montreal? You are close. Champlain, it's Quebec City. Jacques Cartier, Canada. Maisonneuve, sir, exactly. That's a good answer. So in 1642, Paul Chaumédé de Maisonneuve, he was from France. Maisonneuve came here in Montreal, in this area, and he founded a colony dedicated at Mary, at Notre Dame, Our Ladies. And you know, by the way, the first name of Montreal was Ville-Marie, the city of Mary. And when you visit Montreal today, you can see there's many Notre Dame's church, huh? And it's, that's for this reason, because at the beginning, Montreal was a colony dedicated at Notre Dame. So this is the relation. And just a few years after the foundation of the colony, in 1657, a religious order was arrived from Paris, the Sulpicians order, the Sulpicians priest. So they came here and they weren't running the colony. And you know, they had a lot of money. So they want to build a church dedicated at Notre Dame. And the first church that we have in this area was not the actual Notre Dame. I'm going to show you here on the picture. The first, this is the original Notre Dame church. Okay? So in the middle, first church. At the back, we have the old Montreal, the Vieux Montréal, where we are now. And right here, we see the actual Notre Dame. So the other was not so far. It was across the street on the square before, on the Place d'Armes, where you can see today a sculpture of Paul Chaumédé de Maisonneuve, the founder of the colony. And the original Church Notre Dame, it was built from 1672 to 1683, and it was big because for masses and religious celebrations, we can have inside 2,000 visitors. So for a colony, a little colony as Ville-Marie, that was a big monument. But you know, after some years, a few years, the colony was growing up. There was some immigrants. They come here for staying in Montreal and for working near the port. That was easy to find a job. And after a few years, finally, in 1823, the original church on the square was too small. The Sulpician priest won't build a new church, a bigger church, Notre Dame, for this area. And for the new construction that we have today, for this new construction, the Sulpician priest decided to call a famous architect. His name was James O'Donnell. And James O'Donnell, you know, he was not only a famous architect, but he was Irish and Protestant. So, that was a famous, very strange decision. And in 1823, the French Catholic called an Irish and a Protestant to build a Catholic church in Montreal. That was conflicted because the Protestant didn't recognize the authority of the Pope. That was one of the reasons. So, James O'Donnell came here, and the construction, the new construction, was starting in 1824. And, you know, it's amazing. Because James O'Donnell's work on the side every day with 250 men, 7 months per year during 5 years. So after only 35 months on 5 years.
Hey, I met Japanese people inside. Two Japanese girls from some school visiting here for 1 month, they said. Well, that was first Japanese people I've ever met in Montreal. Maybe there are many Japanese people that, but unless listening, I don't know if they're Japanese or Chinese or Korean for sure. So, yeah, if they're speaking Chinese or Korean, I know they're Chinese or Korean. But if even if they're Japanese, I don't know if they're Japanese unless I listen to them listening, speaking Japanese. So, nice. They were like me, like not knowing French, not perfect English. Yeah, they were having trouble like at restaurants or like when ordering because they can't speak, read French. So that was nice to know that there are some Japanese people here, even tourists. This Notre Dame church, Basilica, was impressive, quite impressive. It even made me cry. Like, I don't know, I forgot. Anyway, I'm going somewhere. Oh. That sound of the bell reminds me of elementary, junior, and high school life. Because start and the end of every class, we hear that bell.
Oh my God! Yeah. Do, do, do.